أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط. صدق الله العظيم.
أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. سبح لله ما في السماوات والأرض وهو العزيز الحكيم. له ملك السماوات والأرض يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير. هو الأول والآخر والظاهر والباطن وهو بكل شيء عليم. صدق الله العظيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. Now we are at the most important part of Quran, as I feel, for the Muslim Ummah of today. The Muslim Ummah in decay and degradation. For them, these 10 surahs are the most important part of the Quran. This is the biggest group of the Madani surahs as regards the number. 10 Madani surahs at one place. Surah Al-Hadeed, Surah Al-Mujadilah, Surah Al-Hashr, Surah Al-Mumtahina, Surah Al-Saf, Surah Al-Jum'ah, Surah Al-Munafiqun, Surah Al-Taghabun, Surah Al-Talaq, and Surah Al-Tahrim. 10. Although all these 10 go to make nearly 1¼ of the parts of Quran. In the beginning we have 4, Al-Baqarah, Al-Imran, An-Nisa, Al-Ma'idah. But regarding the volume, they cover more than 6 parts of the Quran. But regarding the number of the surahs, this is the biggest group. The biggest flower pot of the Madani surahs in the Quran. There are certain features which are common to these 10 surahs. Number one, nearly all of them, except one only, and that is Surah Al-Hashr. All the 9 surahs were revealed in the later half period of the stay of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in Medina. Madani period, 10 years. Divide them into 2, 5 plus 5. So all these surahs except Surah Al-Hashr, they were revealed in the later 5-year period. Number two, there is neither any address nor even reference to the mushrikeen of Arabia in these surahs. The idolaters, idol worships, the associators, the pagan people of Arabian Peninsula, no reference. All the address is to the Muslims. Only there are references to the people of the book as a sign, as a warning. O Muslims, now you occupy that position in this world which was occupied by the former Muslim Ummah, the Bani Israel, for 2,000 long years. But then they were removed from this position. Why? These were the weaknesses which came in them. And the same are showing their faces in you also. Although they are in a very primitive stage, but all those weaknesses are showing up. So beware. Try to rectify the conditions. That is why in these surahs we find that addressing the Muslims, a sort of rebuke, a sort of, you know, saying you are not doing this, why you are not doing this, this type you will find very commonly. Then the main subjects of the Quran, which are detailed, which are discussed in detail in the Makki surahs and the long Madani surahs. In these surahs we have summaries of those subjects. Small. Iman is the main subject of the Makki surahs. But here, Surah At-Taghabun, 18 ayat, a complete summary. Nifaq is one of the main subjects of the Madani surahs. Surah An-Nisa, Surah At-Tawbah, Surah Al-Ahzab, Surah Muhammad. But here you have one surah of 11 ayat, Surah Al-Munafiqun, most comprehensive regarding what are the reasons of this disease, etiology, as they call it in medical terminology. What are the symptoms? What is the prognosis? What is the preventive steps that can be taken? And what is the treatment? All these subjects in one surah of 11 ayat. Then the purpose of the advent of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam described at many places. But the most comprehensive is Surah As-Saff, included in this collection. In this way, the summaries of all the important subjects of Quran, the main themes of Quran, you will find in this one part, as volume is one part, one and a quarter. So to say, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to cater to the need of those people also who don't work very hard. So they need summaries, you know. Just like some students, they need some khulasas, you know, and summaries and so on to get through the examinations. So even if these 10 surahs we can understand, I think it will suffice. Now, 5 of these surahs start with Sabbaha lillah or Yusabbihu lillah, with the mention of the fact that everything in this universe is glorifying Allah. They are called Al-Musabbihat, and they have a special importance in this group. 5 Al-Musabbihat, Surah Al-Hadeed, Surah Al-Hashr, Surah Al-Saff, Surah Al-Jum'ah, Surah Al-Taghabun. The rest 5 start directly. And the first surah, that is Surah Al-Hadeed, which we shall shortly be reading, is, so to say, the Ummul Musabbihat, the subject matter of all the Musabbihat, in a nutshell, that is in Surah Al-Hadeed. So I can't give you what I feel actually in my heart. The importance, the grandeur, the majesty of this surah, Surah Al-Hadeed. I don't have words to express myself. And I feel I'm very lucky even. At a very early age, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala produced in my heart a special liking for this surah. So much so that sometimes I dare say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given me this surah. That is, He has given me a very deep insight into this surah, a deep understanding of this surah, Al-Mubarakah. Now we start. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Sabbaha lillahi ma fis samawati wal ard. Everything that is in the heavens and the earth glorifies Allah. Wa huwa al-Azizu al-Hakim. And He is the mighty, all-powerful and the wise, having all the wisdom. What's the meaning of tasbih? Sabaha yasbahu means to float. Floating in water, keeping at the surface, not going down. Floating in the space, keeping its level. Kullun fi falakin yasbahun. Sabaha yusabbihu means to keep something afloat. Not let it go down. To keep Allah afloat, what does it mean? Don't attach any concept with Him which is not becoming for Him. Any weakness? No. Any shortcoming? No. Any need? No. This affirmation of this fact. He is above all defects, above all weaknesses, above all shortcomings, above all mistakes. When you affirm this, this is tasbih. And when you say, He has all the good things in Him, that is hamd or tahmid. Tasbih, tahmid. Tasbih is a negative concept. He is above all these shortcomings and weaknesses, mistakes, nothing. But He has all the high attributes at the highest level. This is hamd. Yusabbihuna bihamdihi. At many places we have read, especially in Surah Bani Israel, وَإِمْ مِنْ شَيْنِ اللَّهِ يُصَبِّحُ بِحَمْدِهِ وَلَاكِ اللَّهِ تَفْقَهُونَ تَصْبِحَهُمْ. There is not a single thing in the whole universe which is not glorifying Allah with praise. But you can't understand their glorification. But one way we can understand, what is it? This universe is glorifying Allah by its presence. See to me, is there any defect in me? No. So who is free from the defect? The one who created me. I am nothing. A painter has painted something. If it is very beautiful, praise goes to whom? To the painting or the painter? So this is the work of Allah, this universe. And by its very existence, everything is testifying that my creator, my planner, my fashioner is above all weaknesses, complete in all respects. This is the glorification of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which everything is doing. Then there can be, maybe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given a tongue to everything of its own. As we have read in Surah Hamim Saita, Antaka Allahu alladhi antaka kulla shay. Our skins will say that now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made us speak also, as He has made everything speak. So maybe they have some their own tongues and they glorify also, which we can't understand. But that aspect is understandable. Secondly, please note in this group of surahs, these two names of Allah, Al-Aziz, Al-Hakim, they are repeated, mostly repeated. Why? They go to give you a complete concept of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala regarding the sovereign of this universe. The sovereign must have total authority. No limits or boundaries on its authority. And number two, we know in this world that wherever there is some authority, there is a tendency to corruption. Authority tends to corrupt. And absolute authority corrupts absolutely. But here, Allah has all the authority, but at the same time, He has all the wisdom. So His authority is used with wisdom. This is the balancing factor for the total authority. No outside limitations, no checks and balances from outside. But His own wisdom keeps His authority on the correct line. And this is the concept, the political concept. Al-Aziz, Al-Hakim. لَهُ مُلْكُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. To Him belongs the sovereignty. Now note this word. The concept of Islam as a deen, as a total system of life. And the highest manifestation of that is the concept of state. All this social structure, you know, it has evolved. And then the highest evolved form of the organized society is the state. لَهُ مُلْكُ السَّمْ. Islam is a state. It wants to establish a state of its own. It doesn't want to live underneath any other sovereignty. Oh, no, no. الْحَقُّ يَعْلُوْ وَلَا يُعْلَى عَلَيْهِ. The truth has the right to dominate, not to be dominated. لَهُ مُلْكُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. To Him belongs the sovereignty of the heavens and the earth. يُحْيِي وَيُمِيتُ. He keeps you alive, He gives you life. And He makes you die. وَهُوَ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ. And He is powerful over everything, everything. هُوَ الْأَوَّلُ وَالْآخِرُ وَالْظَاهِرُ وَالْبَاطِنُ. He is the first and the last and the most manifest and the most hidden. These are four names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and this is the only place in the whole of Quran where you find this wow between the names. Nowhere in the Quran, nowhere else. Even eight names are mentioned in Surah Al-Hashr. Al-Malikul Quddusus Salamul Muminul Muhaiminul Azizul Jabbarul Mutakabbir. No wow in between. No end. Why? Because all these attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are present in His person simultaneously. But here, this is the only place. Awwalo wal akhiro wal zahiro wal batin. Why? Because awwal and akhir can't exist simultaneously. There must be a time gap. Awwal, akhir. Some gap. When there was nothing, He was there. And there will be nothing, and He will be there. So He is the awwal of the creation. And He will be the last of the creation. Creation was not there, He was there. Creation will not be there, He will be there. So He is the beginning and the end of this creation. And between this beginning and end, this universe has two aspects, inner aspect, outer aspect. And from the angle of the outer aspect, He is the most manifest. And from the inner aspect, He is the most hidden. Nobody can know Him. But He is everywhere. نَحْنُ أَقْرَبُ إِلَيْهِ مِنْ حَبْلِ الْوَرِيدِ. We read in Surah Qaf. He is so manifest. All this creation is a manifestation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everything is a sign of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is so evident. So manifest, but He is absolutely hidden. Nobody can know Him, know His person. We know Him only through His attributes, His sifat, His names, not His person. وَهُوَ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عَلِيمٌ. And He knows everything. Now note, these two attributes are most important. هُوَ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ هُوَ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عَلِيمٌ. Power over everything knowledge of everything. Omnipotent, omniscient. Out of the attributes of Allah, they are the most fundamental attributes. هو الذي خلق السماوات والأرض في ستة أيام. It is He who created the heavens and the earth in 6 days or 6 cycles of time or 6 periods of time. ثم استوى على العرش, then He mounted on the throne of power and glory. يعلم ما يلج في الأرض. He knows whatever enters the earth. Each drop of rain entering, He knows it. ويعلم ما وَمَا يَخْرُجُ مِنْهَا Whatever comes out of it, He knows. وَمَا يَنْزُلُ مِنَ السَّمَاءَ Whatever is coming down from the heaven, He knows. وَمَا يَعْرُجُ فِيهَا Whatever is going up into the heaven, He knows. The angels going up. وَهُوَ مَعَكُمْ أَيْنَ مَا كُنْتُمْ He is with you wherever you are. We can't imagine how. And we shouldn't try to understand it how. The how, we should keep separate. But He is. That is must. Huwa ma'akum aina ma kuntum. Wherever you are, He is with you. Now these philosophical questions, you know, led to the discussions. You might have heard these things, wahdatul shahud and wahdatul wujud. Very highly technical discourses. Scholastic discussions. I don't want to even refer to these things. But this is the most important place of Quran regarding this. I have an Urdu dars of Surah Al-Hadeed comprising 15 hours. 29 ayat, 15 hours. For those who feel interested, they can listen to it. Wallahu bima ta'maluna basir. When He is with you wherever you are, so He is seeing for Himself everything you are doing. When He is with you wherever you are, so He is the direct witness. Lahu mulku samawati wal ard. Now note, why repeating this again? This is the most important concept. To Him belongs the sovereignty of the universe and the earth. When people make Islam a religion in the usual sense of the word, this concept of sovereignty of Allah goes off. Pray and fast and this and that and then and Hajj and Umrah, and that's all. Deen is complete. Lahu mulku samawati wal ard. Wa ila Allah turja'ul umur, and all the matters will be made to return to Him. Yuliju al-layla fi an-nahar. He merges the night into the day. Wa yuliju an-nahara fi al-layl. He merges the day into the night. Wa huwa alimun bi zati sudur. And He knows whatever is in the hearts and chests of the people. These 6 ayat, let me say, I again have to admit that I don't have words to express what impression I have in my heart, at what highest level of consciousness and philosophical discourse this person and attributes of Allah has been discussed in these 6 ayat. And this is regarding this, the person and the attributes of Allah. This is the most important, most important, most important ayat, 6th ayat of Surah Al-Hadid. Now this is as it is. Allah is there. Universe belongs to Him. He is the creator. He is the sovereign. What should you do? What does He demand from you? Aminu billahi wa rasulih. Number one, have belief in Allah and His messenger. Wa anfiqu mimma ja'alakum mustakhlafina fih. And expend from whatsoever He has given you vice regency over it. For His pleasure. Whatever He has given you. He has given you this hand, use it for Allah. I am the vice student on my body. I'm Khalifa. Mustakhlafina fi. Allah has given me something. And He has given me, has made me my student. I can use as like. But to keep its use for Allah, all the faculties that Allah has given me, all the capabilities that Allah has bestowed upon me, all the belongings that Allah has given me, expend them. Two words. Aminu anfiqu. Aminu anfiqu. Aminu anfiqu. Note these two words. They will be repeated and repeated and repeated in all these 10 surahs. Have belief as you should have belief. It should reach the level of conviction. And expend in the way of Allah. فَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنْكُمْ وَأَنْفَقُوا. The same two things repeated. So who amongst you believe and spend? لَهُمْ أَجْرٌ كَبِيرٌ. For them is a very great reward. And now is coming the rebuke, as I told you. وَمَا لَكُمْ لَا تُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ. What has happened to you? You don't have faith in Allah? Who are being addressed? The companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Because among the companions, there were all types of people. The Muhajireen, who had passed through hardships, sacrifices, all types of tests and tribulations. Then you know, As-Sabiqun al-Awwaluna min al-Ansar, the early Ansars of Medina. But now every day, new people are coming and entering the fold of Islam. As we read, Qalatil Arabu Amanna, they also say, we claim we are Mu'min. No, you are not Mu'min, you are only Muslims. So what has happened? The average has decreased. Previously, number of Muslims was small, but the intensity of Iman was great. So the average level was high. Now the number is great, but the intensity in the newcomers is not that much. So the average has gone down. And now we are living in an era when this average has reached nearly zero. Do we have Iman? This is the biggest misunderstanding. Very few of the Muslims of today have Iman. They have a creed, a racial creed. They have a dogma, not the conviction, not the Iman in the heart, deep-rooted in the heart. No. Quran says, وَلَا تَهِنُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا أَنْتُمُ الْعَلَوْنَ إِن كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ. If you are true Mu'mins, you will be the uppermost. And we are today the lowermost. What's the logical result? We don't have Iman. Whatever we have is a shadow of Iman. A legal shadow. And I say, I believe. Okay, then you are a Muslim. That's all. قالت الأعراب آمنا قل لم تؤمنوا ولكن قلوا أسلمنا. This is the condition of 99.9 recurrent percent Muslims today. وَمَا لَكُمْ لَا تُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ وَالرَّسُولُ يَدْعُوكُمْ لِتُؤْمِنُوا بِرَبِّكُمْ. And the messenger of Allah is calling you. Still he is present amongst you. Calling you that you should believe in your Lord. وَقَدْ أَخَذَ مِيثَاقَكُمْ. And he had already taken and extracted a covenant from you. إِن كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ. If you are believers. The covenant that you made before coming in this world. أَلَسْتُ بِرَبِّكُمْ. And the second covenant you made when you said, I believe. This belief is a sale-purchase agreement between Allah and you. إِنَّ اللَّهَ اشْتَرَى مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ أَنفُسَهُمْ وَأَمْوَالَهُمْ بِأَنَّ لَهُمُ الْجَنَّةَ. You are under these two covenants. Now, after this rebuke, a guidance to the remedy. If you really, if you peep down into your hearts and you find, yes, there is vacuum type of thing. I don't have that iman. Then where to go to get this iman? هُوَ الَّذِي يُنَزِّلُ عَلَىٰ عَبْدِهِ آيَاتٍ بَيِّنَاتٍ لِيُخْرِجَكُم مِّنَ الظُّلُمَاتِ إِلَى النُّورِ. It is He who is sending down on His bondsman, on His servant, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, these enlightened and illuminating ayat, revelations, لِيُخْرِجَكُم, so that He brings you out, مِّنَ الظُّلُمَاتِ إِلَى النُّورِ, from the darknesses into the light. You have the source material of iman, you have in your house, you have in your possession, and that is Quran. Only you have to read it, only you have to ponder over it, only you have to dive deep into its meanings, that's all. You don't have to go to any caves or any woods or any far away from human society and everything. No, no. Wherever you are, take this book, ponder over it, read it, dive deep into its meanings. It will stir in you that dormant consciousness which is already present in you, but it is dormant, inactive. It will be activated. هُوَ الَّذِي يُنَزِّلُ عَلَىٰ عَبْدِهِ آيَاتٍ بَيِّنَاتٍ لِيُخْرِجَكُم مِّنَ الظُّلُمَاتِ إِلَى النُّورِ وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ بِكُمْ لَرَءُوفٌ رَحِيمٌ. Verily Allah is for you very kind and very merciful. And the biggest manifestation of His mercy is Quran. الرَّحْمَنُ عَلَّمَ الْقُرْآنِ. The manifestation of Rahmaniyah of Allah is Quran. Now second, there were two demands, Aminu and Anfiqu. This is very systematic. The first rebuke, why don't you have faith? Now the second rebuke. وَمَا لَكُمْ أَلَّا تُنْفِقُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. What has happened to you? You don't want to spend in the way of Allah. You want to keep your money, your wealth. Why? What has happened to you? This is not iman. This doesn't become of a true mu'min. If he believes in the hereafter, he must deposit everything in the bank of the hereafter. Why is he depositing here? From where he has to go anyhow. Whether this wealth remains with you or not, but you have to depart from here. And you are keeping it here. It means you don't have, you don't really believe in the hereafter. Whatever you spend for the cause of Allah, it is deposited in the divine bank of the hereafter. وَمَا لَكُمْ أَلَّا تُنْفِقُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ وَلِلَّهِ مِيرَاثُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. The final inheritance of everything, all the heavens and the earth, will go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You will all vanish. What will remain? For whom? Who will be the inheritor? لا يستوي منكم من أنفق من قبل الفتح. Very important point. Those of you are not equal to the others who spent before the victory and fought in the way of Allah. Now you know this, just as you know, if there is a flower bud, the petals are there but they are not visible. When it opens, now the petals become visible. In the same way, in the beginning was anfiqu only. Aminu billahi wa rasulihi wa anfiqu. Mimma ja'alakum mustakhlifina fi. Now we found anfiqu fi sabilillah. This infaq is for the cause of Allah. And now we found wa qatalu. Qital is also infaq. Spending your life for Allah is qital. Infaq-e maal, infaq-e jaan. Bazl-e maal, bazl-e jaan. So when it is, was said, anfiqu, mimma ja'alakum mustakhlifina fi, potentially it contained in it The qital also. Here it is opening. لا يستوي منكم من انفق من قبل الفتح. Those of you who spent for the cause of Allah before victory and also fought for the cause of Allah, they are not equal to others. أولئك أعظم درجة. They are much in the ranks of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are very high. Then those من الذين انفقوا من بعد وقاتلوا, who spent in the way of Allah but after the victory, and they took part in the fighting in the cause of Allah but after the victory. When Muslims were weak, whosoever was striving for Islam at that time, well, he has a very high position. Then when Islam has become a power, now with the powerful everybody wants to walk. So the ranks are very different. وَكُلَّ وَعَدَ اللَّهُ الْحُسْنَى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised to all very good. وَاللَّهُ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ خَبِيرٌ. Whatever you are doing, Allah is aware of it. مَنْ ذَا الَّذِي يُقْرِضُ اللَّهَ قَرْضًا حَسَنًا. Who is that courageous person who gives a goodly loan to Allah? Listen, Allah, to Him belongs everything, and He is demanding loan. What does it mean? It's an appreciation. You spend something for me and my deen, so it's a loan to me. But to give loan to Allah, for that you need courage. Why? For that you have to have the belief and conviction. Conviction in the existence of Allah, conviction in the resurrection, conviction in the hereafter. Then only you can extend a loan to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not without these things. So, man zal lazi. This is a very challenging attitude, style. Kaun hota hai harife mai mard afghani ash isq. Hai mukarrar lame saaki pe sala mere baad. Who is who? Man zal lazi yuqridu Allah qarzan hasanan. Fa yudaifahu lahu. So Allah will keep on doubling it many folds. وَلَهُ أَجْرٌ كَرِيمٌ. And in addition, there will be a very generous reward. Now, a scene is now being shown, the day of judgment. A certain stage is where people will have to cross, it seems, a bridge, which we call in Urdu, Pul Sirat. This As-Siratul Mustaqim fi dunya, in this world, then it becomes As-Sirat in the other world. And you have to pass over it. Underneath is the hell. Those who were considered Muslims in this world, those who were kuffar, their cases have already been decided, gone with the wind. But those who were counted as Muslims, now they have to be screened. Who among them had real faith and who was a hypocrite? For that, you will be made to pass through over a bridge where is absolute darkness. But those who had real iman, they will have light, light of iman in their hearts. So that torch will be showing them the passage. And because they have earned good deeds with the right hands, so there will be a light on the right side also. With this help, they will pass. But those who considered themselves Muslims, or they were considered Muslim by the others in this world, but didn't have the real iman or real good deeds, they will have no light. So they will stagger and fall down. يَوْمَ تَرَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتِ. The day when you will see the really believing Muslim men and really believing Muslim women. نُورُهُمْ يَسْعَى نُورُهُمْ. Their light will be running بَيْنَ أَيْدِيهِمْ, in front of them. وَبِأَيْمَانِهِمْ, and to the right of them. بُشْرَاكُمُ الْيَوْمَ جَنَّاتِ. It will be said to them, for you are the glad tidings today of the gardens, tajri min tahti al-anhar, underneath which rivers are flowing, khalidina fiha, and you will remain in these gardens forever, forever. Zalika huwa al-fawzul azim. And this is the great success. But what about the munafiqeen? يَوْمَ يَقُولُ الْمُنَافِقُونَ وَالْمُنَافِقَاتُ. On that day, the hypocrite men and women, they will say to the believers, لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا انْظُرُونَا. Please wait for us. We don't have any light. Just imagine, if you are crossing some jungle during the night, and somebody has a torch, and he is going, you know, you say, just wait for me also. I don't have a torch. I should avail the light of your torch. In the same way, when the believing men and women will be going, because they have the light, they are seeing the path, then this munafiqun would say, unzuruna naqtabis min nurikum. Wait for us, so that we can also benefit, and we borrow from your light. It will be said, go back. This light was earned in that world, which is now past. Iman was earned over there. Good deeds were earned over there. This light has not been given here as a charity. It was earned in that world. If it is possible for you, go back to that world and try to earn. Qilad yawwaraakum faltamisu noora. Try to get that light. فَزُرِبَ بَيْنَهُمْ مِسُورٍ لَهُ بَابٍ. In the meantime, a wall will be erected between the two. بَاطِنُهُ لَهُ بَابٍ. There will be a door also in that. بَاطِنُهُ فِي الرَّحْمَةِ. In the inside of that wall will be the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The hospitality for the people of Jannah will start. وَزَاهِرَهُ مِنْ قِبَلِهِ. And the outside of it, before it, there will be the torment and the chastisement. Now they have been screened out of the Muslims. The really believing moments have passed. And the hypocrites, they remain back. يُنَادُونَهُ وَلَمْ نَكُمْ مَعَكُمْ. They will call to them, were we not with you? He says, not there, we are here. Why? We were there in the world. We were also Muslims. We were praying before Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam in the mosque. Were we not? أَلَمْ نَكُمْ مَعَكُمْ. قَالُوا بَلَىٰ. They will say, why not? They were with us. You were with us. وَلَاكِنَّكُمْ فَتَنْتُمْ أَنفُسَكُمْ. But you gave up yourself to the temptations of that life. More money, more position, more fame. Overindulgence in these things. You put yourself into that fitna. Fatantum anfusakum. With your own hands, you put yourself in that fitna. Watarabbastum. And then you started waiting. What happens? Let us wait and see. To whom goes the victory? To Muhammad and his companions? Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa radiyallahu ta'ala anhum? Or the enemies? Vartabtum. And then doubts started coming up into your hearts. وَغَرَتْكُمُ الْأَمَانِي. And then your willful thinkings, false hopes, deluded you. Oh, Allah is merciful. Allah will forgive. حَتَّى جَاءَ أَمْرُ اللَّهِ. Until the final command of Allah came. وَغَرَّكُمْ بِاللَّهِ الْغَرُورِ. And definitely that arc deceit, Satan, he misguided you in the name of Allah and His mercy. فَالْيَوْمَ لَا يُخَذُ مِنْكُمْ فِدْيَةٌ. So today, no ransom will be accepted from you. وَلَا مِنَ الَّذِينَ كَفِرُوا. Nor from the unbelievers. In that world, you were with us, with the believing people. Because you were also taken to be Muslims. Here you are with the kuffar. فَالْيَوْمَ لَا يُخَذُ مِنْكُمْ فِدْيَةٌ وَلَا مِنَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. Now you are one category. You and the kuffar. مَا وَاكُمُ النَّارِ. For all of you, the permanent abode is fire. هِيَ مَوْلَاكُمْ. She is your patron now. مَوْلَاكُمْ. Whatever you have to say, say to this fire. جو دکھ سکھ کرنا ہو اسی سے کرو. Nobody else to listen to your moans and groans and lamenting. وَبِئْسَ الْمَصِيرُ. And it's a very bad and evil destination. Now, in these ayat, a very big question mark comes to us. There's a very beautiful couplet in Persian. جانِ جملہ علم ہائی نست بس. ای نست ای جانِ جملہ علم ہائی نست ای تابدانی من قیم در یوم دین. The essence of all knowledge is this only, that you should be able to know where will you stand on the day of the judgment. If you have read books and Tafseer and Al-Hadeed and Fiqh and this, but you are not worried where you are. Where will you be placed on the day of the judgment? About which even Muhammad says, وَإِنْ أَدْرِي مَا يُفَلُوا بِي وَلَا بِكُمْ. I don't know what will be done to me or to you. But we feel safe. Our salvation vouchsafes for to us. All these threats are for the kuffar, not for us. We are Muslims. If we are Muslims, we are Mu'mins. When we are Mu'mins, Jannah is going to be our abode. No question. But we must understand, where do we stand? And then now a question. أَلَمْ يَعْنِ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَنْ تَخْشَعَ قُلُوبُهُمْ لِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَمَا نَزَلَ مِنَ الْحَقِّ. Has the time not come up till now for those who profess to believe, that their hearts should humble for the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and for the truth that has been revealed? وَلَا يَكُونُوا كَالَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ مِنْ قَبْلُ. They should not be like those who were given the book before them. This is the reference of Yahud. I told you in the beginning. No address to Yahud, but a reference. فَتَعَلَى عَلَيْهِمُ الْأَمَدُ. Then their period became lengthened or prolonged. فَقَسَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ. And their hearts hardened. وَكَسِيرُ مِنْهُمْ فَاسِقُونَ. And most of them are transgressors. This hardening of the hearts about which in Surah Al-Baqarah we find, ثُمَّ قَسَتْ قُلُوبُكُمْ فَهِيَ كَالْحِجَارَةِ وَشَدُّ قَسْوَةِ. And then your hearts hardened, and now they have become as hard as stones, rather harder than the stones. This is the condition of the hearts of human beings when they are hardened. So, if you are alarmed, yes, this is time I mend my ways. This is the time I repent. This is the time I should turn sincerely to Allah and His Deen. Then, a ray of hope. Elamu, let this be known to you. أَنَّ اللَّهَ يُحْيِي الْأَرْضَ بَعْدَ مَوْتِهَا. That Allah revives the land, earth, after its death. So if your hearts have died, Allah can revive your hearts also. If you feel there, your hearts are barren regarding the crop of Iman, no, Allah can give you the crop. So don't be despaired, don't be disappointed. Because if you are despaired and disappointed, then there's no possibility of mending and rectifying your ways. For that you need the courage and hope. So see, Allah revives the land, dead land, after its death. It will revive your hearts also. قَدْبَيَّنَّا لَكُمُ الْآيَاتِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَعْخِلُونَ We have made clear our revelations to you so that you can understand and you ponder over it. But you have to plow the land. The land is barren. You need two things. Plow, sow the seed, wait for the rain. So, if your hearts are dead, if your hearts are barren, now you have to plow it. And what is the plowing of this land of heart? إِنَّ الْمُصَّدِّقِينَ وَالْمُصَّدِّقَاتِ وَأَقْرَضُ اللَّهَ قَرْضًا حَسَنًا Verily those who give alms for the pleasure of Allah, men and women, and those who give loan to their Lord, goodly loan, يُضَعَفُ لَهُمْ وَلَهُمْ أَجْرٌ كَرِيمٌ It will be kept doubled for them. And there will be a very generous reward also, respectable reward also. This is the plowing of this land of heart. Get out from it the love for wealth. The main disease is the love of this world. And the biggest manifestation of the love of this world is the love of wealth. Get it out, get it out, get it out. وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرُسُولِهِ Now after this, when the impurities from this earth of your heart has been removed by plowing, now if you sow the seeds of Iman, وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرُسُولِهِ And there we should read the understood words, مَاذَا ذَلِكَ Not mentioned, محزوف, understood. If clearing your heart of the love for wealth, after clearing your heart of the wealth, love of wealth, then you sow the seed of Iman. And now you will have the full harvest. وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرُسُلِهِ أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الصِّدِّيقُونَ Now they can go rise to the level of Siddiqeen. This is the highest level. Next to Anbiya. أُولَٰئِكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ وَالصِّدِّيقِينَ وَالشُّهَدَاءِ وَالصَّالِحِينَ Now you can rise to Siddiqeen وَالشُّهَدَاء You can be the witnesses of Allah on this earth. Living witnesses. Shaheed is not only the one who has given his life for the cause of Allah. A living Shaheed is the witness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Are you here among the Christians, Jehovah's Witnesses? This is the correct word, witnesses. Whosoever practices the deen of Allah is by his very practice a witness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَهُمْ أَجْرُهُمْ وَنُورُهُمْ For them there will be their reward and the light. They will get the light which will show you the path on that day and you will be able to cross that as-sirat. وَالَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا وَكَذَّبُوا بِآيَاتِنَا As for those who reject and belie our revelations, أُولَٰئِكَ أَصْحَابُ الْجَحِيمِ They are the people of the fire, dwellers of the fire. إِلَمُوا Now in a few ayat, now the crux of the matter is this world or that world. Which do you want really? مَنْ كَانَ يُرِيدُ حَرْسَ الْآخِرَةِ نَجِدْ لَهُ فِي حَرْسِهِ وَمَنْ كَانَ يُرِيدُ حَرْسَ الدُّنْيَا نُوتِهِ مِنْهَا وَمَا لَهُ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنْ نَصِيبٍ Crucial question is, you are after this world or that world? If you are after this world, that world, hereafter, You have to use this world to earn that hereafter. But if this becomes an end in itself, then you are doomed. اعلموا انما الحياة الدنيا لعب ولهو وزينة وتفاخر بينكم وتكاثر في الاموال والاولاد. Let it be known to you that the life of this world is nothing but a play, an amusement, an adornment, a boasting among yourselves, and a rivalry in abundance of riches and children. اعلموا انما الحياة الدنيا لعب ولهو وزينة وتفاخر بينكم وتكاثر في الاموال والاولاد. These are the five stages of human life. Early childhood, life is nothing but play. Innocent play. When you are in the teenager stage, now there is not only play, innocent play, amusement and sensual gratification that come. And also adornment. I must have very good dress. My hair very beautifully cut. I should have the clothing of the fashion of that time. Tafakhurum bainakum. And then at a stage, when you are nearing 30, now boasting, I have more wealth, I have more power, I have a better car. And finally you are past the age of 40, then nothing except more and more wealth and more children. This thing, children, this has stopped now in this world. But before, you know, in that time, because they were the source of strength, the person who had more sons, he was more strong, more respectable. But you know, now this Al-Hakum al-Takasur is only for riches, riches, riches. Kamasali Ghaisin. The similitude is that of rain. عَجَبَ الْكُفَّارَ نَبَاتُهُ. Rain and the resulting vegetation that pleases the husbandman. فَتَرَاهُ ثُمَّ يَهِيجُ فَتَرَاهُ مُصْفَرًا ثُمَّ يَكُونُ حُطَامًا. And then it crumbles. To see it turning yellow, then it becomes shaffer or straw. This is, you know, a life cycle. The land was lying dead. Rain fell. Now there is vegetation, maybe grass or some crop. But then after some time, this becomes yellow. And then, you know, it becomes chaff or straws and nothing else. So this is a few months. And human life cycle is the same. A new child is born, then he grows up. He reaches his maturity, strong. Then, you know, they decline. Then gray hair, then dead, and buried in the grave. This is a cycle of 30, 40, 60, 70 years, and this is a few months. وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ عَذَابٌ شَدِيدٌ وَمَغْفِرَةٌ مِنَ اللَّهِ وَرِضْوَانٌ. But in the hereafter, one of the two ends are essential. Either عَذَابٌ شَدِيدٌ, a very severe chastisement. وَمَغْفِرَةٌ مِنَ اللَّهِ وَرِضْوَانٌ. And the other, forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His pleasure. Now choose where you want to go. If you have decided that you desire this world, then the severe punishment in the hereafter. If you decide here that you want the other world and Allah, then there will be forgiveness and the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَا الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا مَتَعُ الْغُرُورِ. And this life of this world is nothing but a comfort of illusion. When it's obstructs your vision of the akhirah, this dunya. If it obstructs your vision of akhirah, then it is ghurur, it is dhoka, it's fareb, it's dajjal, it's dajjal. This dunya is dajjal, actually. The intensity of this dunya will increase and increase and increase, reaching that level of dajjal. But our ghurur, this is illusion. But if you believe in akhirah, you aim at akhirah, you use this to earn akhirah, you sow here to reap in the akhirah, then this world, this life is very important, very precious. Each minute, each second of it. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بالآيات والذكر الحكيم.
الله أكبر الله أكبر.
The Islamic Organization of North America, IONA, is an organization dedicated to reviving the Quran into the hearts of Muslims while bringing its message to non-Muslims. The obligations of a Muslim as ordained by the Quran and Sunnah can be understood as having four levels. 1. A Muslim is required to develop real faith and conviction, iman, in one's heart. 2. A Muslim is required to live a life of complete submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 3. A Muslim is required to propagate and disseminate the message of Islam to humanity as a whole. 4. A Muslim is required to try his utmost in establishing the just Islamic order. The first and foremost objective of establishing IONA is to assist the Muslims in North America to uphold and implement these obligations, first on themselves, their families, inform their friends, and then to invite the non-Muslims to Islam. The ultimate goal is to seek Allah's pleasure and salvation in the hereafter. For more information about IONA, please visit us at www.tanzeem.us. You may also email us at info@tanzeem.us or call our toll-free number 866-779-IONA. Join us. Together we can make a difference.